Hey everyone, welcome back to another amazing video. Today we're checking out Adobe XD's June update, which is update number 30. And this is a very exciting update for all my Adobe XD users out there because there are a lot of major changes. Also guys, I am hosting a demo class for my new design school, which is India's most affordable design school. So sign up and register for that demo class for this Sunday. I'll give a link in the description. If you're interested, go ahead, sign up. So the first thing is, of course, the logo or the icon that you see across Adobe. I feel this makes it look much more mature and I'm really, really digging it. So the first feature, guys, is scroll groups. And scroll groups allows you to create horizontal, vertical, and free scroll or around a certain area. I'll show you what I mean by that. So as you can see, I have placed a lot of these elements right next to each other. These are basically just rectangles. I will just drag out and select all the elements that I want in a scroll group. And on the right below height in the right panel, we have these three little features that have been added: horizontal scroll, vertical scroll, and horizontal plus vertical scroll, which is free scroll. So what we'll do is we'll test out each one of these. The first one is horizontal scroll. As you can see, when I've clicked this, it now fits it inside a certain area, which as you can see, there are these little handles right here, which I can adjust and fit the horizontal area. So I just want this much area, maybe. Yeah, that's fine. And that is horizontal area. I'll just place it in the center to make it a little more convenient. And everything inside that will also move together. So if I click on this, click on preview, as you can see, I can now, just using my scroll bar on my computer or anywhere else, I can just scroll through these items in a horizontal way. And as you can see, there's this little spring effect at the end on the left. As you can see, when I'm just scrolling at the end, there's the little very clean spring effect that you get on your phones as well. Vertical scroll, of course, works as it sounds. If I just click on this and just create a vertical scroll like this, if I play a preview, I can always scroll just like this. This looks so, so good. And of course, it all adds up when you have this free scroll or horizontal and vertical scroll. What it allows you to do is scroll in all and every direction. So I'll just create this much of space and put it in the center right here. And I'll play this preview very simply. And as you can see, I can basically scroll in any direction. Wow, this looks incredible. Now, the next cool feature that they're introducing is called Stacks. And Stacks works very similar to what you find in Figma and Sketch, where you can replace one item with the other item in a certain group. I will just select all of these and say Command K or Control K on your keyboard to create a component. This will work mainly for components. And as you can see on the right, under this responsive resize option, we have stacks. And it works very simply. Of course, you can add a stack, which enables padding by default. So in this case, what I can do is just select one of these items and replace one of these items with other items right here. And I can do the same with the green element right here. How cool is that? This makes designing larger projects so much more easier and simpler. I can even reduce individual space between all of these elements. And that is really cool because that will help you just quickly change spaces very, very easily. And of course, you can adjust the padding of each of these elements simply from here. If you just change, say, one padding, the first padding being 56. So there'll be 56 pixels over the first element, and the last will be 56 over the left element, just like that. It's as simple as that, guys. Now the next feature is called design tokens. And you might be wondering, what's a token? Well, you can basically name each element here, and it will reflect when you are sharing it with a developer. I'll show you how you can do that real quick. If I right click here and I say add color to assets, that's cool. So if a developer opens his desktop and opens this code right here and selects this color blue, as you can see, the friendly blue color is right now available. It's marked friendly blue. As you can see, the same thing has been done here in the color properties right here, background variable friendly blue. And I think that's a really cool feature, especially for developers to identify different colors. For example, if you have three different shades of blue, it's easy to identify one shade of blue from the other. Except that there are very simple features that have been introduced, but it's still a change. Hope you guys liked that video. If you did, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. That really helps me out. Also click that bell icon right next to the subscribe button. Like this video if you did, and keep on watching. I post every Monday and Thursday, same time. God bless.